each episode of Lyft Comics, six unsuspecting passengers who have the rides of their lives.
What? No.
Because their Lyft drivers are actually comedians.
Yes!
Competing to make them laugh in this game show on wheels. I'm Kevin Hart, and this is Lyft Comics. Today, two new comedians, Emily and TJ, going head to head. Funniest ride wins.
I live in Queens and I'm a stand-up comic.
We're on our way to pick up the first person.
What I love about stand-up is interacting with the audience.
I was born in Haiti. I've been a comic for 8 years. This is a nice upgrade and I'd like to keep it when this is over. I don't have any strategy. I just want to have fun.
The comedians will each try to make three different passengers laugh. The comedian with the best rating at the end wins the prize.
We'll see how this goes.
Let's do this, our first passenger. Now remember, neither passenger has any idea that their driver is a comedian that's competing to make them laugh.
Hi, Kimberly?
Hi, yes.
Hi, come on in.
Welcome to the Lyft, Franz. How you doing?
You have like, you're a very put together person. You've got like a very distinct style. I got really dressed up to drive you around today. I don't know if you could tell. They say that you should dress for the job that you want, and I want to be your dad.
I have a thing with names. People's names are interesting to me. Sometimes I meet people and their name doesn't match. I recently met an old guy, 97 years old. Really old, almost dead at this point, I'd say. And this 97-year-old guy, you know what his name was? Kevin. You can't be Kevin at 97.
Nah.
Nobody's gonna sit by a fire listening to the wisdom of Kevin. Kevin is trying to be a DJ.
Your 30s are weird. You're like, oh, I'm so like young and you know, I can go out and have like two beers on a Tuesday, but I can't have caffeine after five. And I feel like all my friends that I grew up with got like houses and spouses and plants and a bunch of other stuff that loves them back. I feel like most of my friends in New York City would smoke a cigarette if they found it on the ground.
You know what I was thinking about the other day? How looks don't matter as much for men as they do for women. Like Jay-Z and Beyonce are in a relationship. Those are not equally attractive people. If Jay-Z was an average dude in Brooklyn, there's no way he'd be with Beyonce. Jay-Z would be dating at most Whoopi Goldberg. That's where he would end. Not the Queen Bee.
So I've been trying to bond with my fiance's family. They're from this really tiny town in Pennsylvania called, if you want my gun, you can come and get it. They like me, though. They have a really cute nickname for me. They call me the Democrat.
I was in a small town near Boston. Cool town. Good food, smart people, but very unattractive town. And there's something weird about that, when an entire town is unfuckable. You know what it felt like being in that town for 4 days? You know when you go to the restroom and you gotta take a dump, but it's dirty? So you say to yourself, you know what? I'll hold it.
Well, I hope you had a lovely ride.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah.
Appreciate it.
So I'm actually a stand-up comedian, and you're on a hidden camera show called Lyft Comics.
You have now been part of Lyft Comics, and I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for being with me.
Thank you.
How did our drivers do?
It was pretty funny and outlandish and very unusual.
I think she hopefully had a good time.
I would give her 4. I've never really had a driver be this outgoing.
I thought he was funny.
We shared some good stuff. I think he was laughing, so I feel good about it.
I would definitely give him a 3. Definitely a nice guy, and I'd like to hang out with him.
4 stars to 3 stars. On to the next ride. Be funny.
I was talking way too fast, so hopefully slow down a little bit. Hey.
Hi, Stephanie. How are you?
Hi, Vivian.
Hello.
How are you today?
I'm good, and you?
My name is TJ, because I have a really difficult and ethnic name to pronounce. But my real name is Thomas Jefferson, so that's what I use to make it easy for people. I don't look like a Thomas Jefferson. I don't. Maybe one of his kids, but not him.
I have a bunch of dating app ideas. The first one, you just upload it if you have any criminal history, and then it's called Literal Partner in Crime.
Okay.
We got a Scissor Sisters. That is if you're a lesbian who likes to coupon.
Okay.
And then I got, it's called Friends with Benefits, and it's for people without health insurance to find some people that do have health insurance.
Yes, that one.
You ever go to New York?
Yeah.
New York is just, it's tough. Like, sometimes I see people that live in New York and they go, well, I am an accountant. Like, why? There's no reason for you to be. You could be killing it as an accountant in Ohio.
I feel like your first kiss and your first, like, crush say a lot about you.
Yeah.
And, like, my first kiss was behind an empty above-ground swimming pool. Like, oh, this really? Is what you grow up into when that is the case.
Your parents have so many dreams that you ruin by being born. You ever think about that? You ever catch your parents looking at you without saying anything?
Yeah, stealing their
that,
dreams.
That silence, you see, that's the sound of disappointment. Your dad is like, I could have had a boat by now, but I had to put you to school.
People have been thinking I was gay since I was like 15, and it doesn't bother me, but it happens a lot, so I've been trying to figure out, you know, why it happens. Like, I don't know if it's because I have, like, a little bit of a deeper voice, or maybe it's because I think this is a good outfit, or maybe it's because I have enough hammers that I have a favorite one.
Okay.
All right, well, Stephanie, I think this is the end of your ride.
Thank you.
And I have a secret to tell you. You on a hidden camera show, and this is called Lyft Comics. So okay. I hope you had a good time.
I'm a stand-up comedian, and you've been on a hidden camera show called Lyft Comics.
Okay.
What did our second passengers think?
Normally I'm on my phone, so I had to get used to someone talking to me for the whole ride.
I think she was a little shy at times. I had to kind of bring her out of her comfort zone.
I would give TJ a 4-star. I would totally go see him at a show, and I'd love it if I could have a glass of wine.
It was funny. It was nice.
That was awesome.
1 to 5, I would give a 3.
Oh, Ty, how exciting. 7 stars apiece. Last ride, come on, let's do it.
Hi, Sean.
Hi, how are you today?
Good, how are you?
Doing well, thanks.
You are very chipper.
All right, get in here, buddy.
How you doing, man?
Do you have, like, any style icons? Anybody you try to dress like when you get dressed in the morning?
I never really thought about it.
I feel like, unintentionally or not, when I get dressed in the morning, I feel like I always kind of look like a mean barista.
I used to live in Utah. Utah is weird, man. Have you ever been in a place where you felt like a tourist attraction? People used to recommend me as a thing to do. You know, there's 3 things you gotta do when you come to Utah. You gotta go to Zion National Park. You gotta go to Salt Lake City to see the salt flats, and you gotta go see the black guy. We just got one.
You actually remind me of my fiance. He is also what you might call like a sweetie pie. When he eats Ben and Jerry's ice cream, he calls it Benjamin and Gerald's.
When I was a kid, we had dogs. And when I came to America, I learned about this brand new crazy concept called dog food. That's not a thing where I'm from. So I'm like, okay, how do they know it tastes good? Who tastes dog food when they're trying to make it better?
I feel like dating right now is like writing letters in the war. You're like, I hope someday to see your face. Like, I hope someday we can hold hands, perhaps on a bench.
Yeah.
I gotta tell you, I'm actually a stand-up comedian, and you've been on a hidden camera show called Lyft Comics.
So cool.
This is a hidden camera show, and you've been riding with me. I'm a stand-up comedian.
What?
Time for the final ratings and the winner of Lyft Comics.
I do think she was funny. I think she did a very good job delivering her material.
Sean was great. I think we could be best friends.
On a 1 to 5 rating, I would give her a 5. She was that good.
12 stars for Emily, which now means TJ also needs a perfect 5 stars to tie.
It was all right. I think I kind of made him a little bit nervous, but he was funny.
It was fine. It wasn't a disaster.
It'd be like a solid 3. I just felt like I brought more out of him.
Emily is our winner.
Well, awesome. Thank you.
Yeah.
I want to thank Sean for being the most positive passenger. And as always, I want to thank my fiance for letting me make fun of him all the time on stage and in front of strangers.
I had a good time. I enjoyed it. So for me, it was just about having fun.
I'm Kevin Hart, and this is Lyft Comics. I'll see y'all later.